The family members of a Panama City woman who was brutally murdered almost 30 years ago were back in court today, reliving their pain and anguish. Lisa Redd's siblings and a cousin gave emotional testimony during her killer's resentencing hearing. But as News 13's Anna Hoffman tells us, the killer, Roderick Orme, was not even there to hear it.
Lisa does not have a voice in this case. Her family does.
One by one, family members of Lisa Redd took the stand to persuade Judge Brantley Clark that her killer, Roderick Michael Orme, deserves the death penalty.
You stole from them the light of their life and disregarded Lisa as if she was nothing.
Redd's sister, Carol Atwell, gave her own testimony, then read powerful impact letters written by those who knew Redd best. They described Redd's personality and life goals that Orme ripped away.
The pains my family have endured for the past 2 decades cannot be verbally expressed. This person's actions has left a huge hole in our family.
Redd was a nurse. She knew Roderick Orme, who was a drug addict. In 1992, he called her and asked her to help him at Lee's motel where he was living. She showed up and Orme raped Redd, then beat her and strangled her to death. A jury convicted him and a judge sentenced him to death row. This latest resentencing is the result of a high court decision requiring a unanimous jury verdict for the death penalty.
In the past, has fought court saying he's innocent. Only now, after his parents have passed, he admits to robbing, raping, and killing her.
In April, Orme testified he no longer wished to fight and he is ready to die.
I'm not suicidal. I don't want to die. I can't bear what I have done any longer.
He waived his right to appear at this hearing.
Therefore, Your Honor, we would submit, the people of the state of Florida would submit, that the only appropriate punishment in this case.
Impose a life sentence on this man, Your Honor, I would submit, and do not give him what he wants.
In Wednesday's hearing, Judge Clark did not make any set decisions as to if Orme should still get the death penalty or if he should be sentenced to life in prison. He did, however, set a pretrial date for March 3rd where Orme will be present in court. In Panama City, Anna Hoffman, News 13, Panhandle Strong.